How's everybody doing? I hope everybody's doing well tonight. How you doing, John? Good. I want to read a scripture to you tonight. Can you hear me? I want to read a scripture to you tonight. Something that I've been thinking for the past few days. You know, one thing that I realized during my growing as a Christian is that we should be happy for other people when good things happen to them. And it doesn't matter whether you agree with what's happening in that person's life or not. You still have to rejoice if it's something that comes from the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. You know, regardless of whatever idea we might have of what we think should happen in that person's life, it is not up to us to dictate where that person is going to go, because it's a decision that individual has to make on their own.
Right.
As I was thinking about this, I started looking for a scripture that talks about this, and I was led to Romans 12, and I want to start reading from verse 3. It says, "For by grace given to me, I say to everyone among you not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body we have many members, and the members do not all have the same function, so we, though many, are one body in Christ, and individually members one of another. Having gifts that differ according to the grace given to us, let us use them. If prophecy, in proportion to our faith. If service, in our serving. The one who teaches, in his teaching. The one who exhorts, in his exhortation. The one who contributes, in generosity. The one who leads, with zeal. The one who does acts of mercy, with cheerfulness. Let love be genuine. Abhor what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with brotherly affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not be slothful in zeal. Be fervent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in tribulation. Be constant in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints and seek to show hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Never be wise in your own sight. Repay no one evil for evil, but give thought to do what is honorable in the sight of all. If possible, so far as it depends on you, live peaceably with all. Beloved, never avenge yourselves, but leave it to the wrath of God, for it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, says the Lord. To the contrary, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. For by doing so, you will heap burning coals on his head. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good." If it says in here that you should be good to your enemy, shouldn't it be easier to be good to your friend?
Yeah.
so we need to think about these things, and you know, the Lord has a plan for each one of us. It doesn't matter what my opinion is of what I think your life needs to go, in what direction, or for whoever. If something good happens to you and it's from God, I'm going to be happy. Not only because I celebrate your joy with you, but he's telling us right here that that's what we should do.
That's right.
So I was thinking about that, and I just wanted to speak to that. You know, let's constantly remind ourselves that regardless of what we think, it's our human condition that is putting all those thoughts in our mind, our flesh. Let's just focus on the things of above, and when something good happens to someone else, let's rejoice and celebrate with them.
Amen.
Any prayer requests or testimonies? I see you. Yeah, Mike. Lift him up. Yes, ma'am.
I just found out that either my transmission or my clutch is out of my truck, so I'm up here and no transportation, so pray for me.
Amen.
Bless you all for provision.
Yeah, real hard.
Anyone else? Sheila.
I went to a house yesterday and kind of found the circumstances there odd, so the grandson walked out of the room, the mother shared with me that her son, who's like 35 years old, died the day before, so just pray for the Anderson family.
Lift him up. Yes.
Pray for my other aunt that is left over there in the house by herself. I was just telling the pastor. If you don't mind, I'll tell everybody what happened.
Sure.
Okay. January 24th, my aunt was murdered over here on Pioneer Road on the south side. And she served God all her life, served, taught everywhere she went. I don't know if anybody remembers the can lady that walked all around the city pushing a buggy. Shopping cart?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's my aunt, and they murdered her in her own home for $200 or $300 from walking home from the ATM.
Did she have to walk through the ATM?
No. But my other aunt that lives there is by herself and she's crippled. So, but they found the murderer. But anyway, my aunts lived together all their lives. So she's completely by herself now. And I worry about her being up there by herself in that big old house over there. You know where Gilbris is on the corner there?
Mm-hmm.
It's a house right next door to Gilbris. And it was all dark. And that's, you know, that's why that man went in there and killed her. But she got his DNA. She fought him back and got his DNA all over the place. And when they shot him and killed him in Urbandale, they knew it was his DNA, so they knew it was him. But I'm still so worried about my other aunt. She's crippled and she's over there completely by herself. You know, nobody to help her. You know, so pray for my Aunt Nita. Anyway, she, you know, that's.
Yep.
And then, you know, my dad, my family, my kids, my friends.
Sure. Amen.
Anyone else? Okay, let's stand. And let's come to the Lord tonight. Father, we thank
you
for bringing us tonight here in this place to be gathered in your presence. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings that you give us, for your promises. We thank you, Lord, because we know that you protect us every day. So we declare right now, Father, that you are with us wherever we go. that we have your divine protection surrounding us at all times. We thank you, Father, because you provide for us for our every need. We cast all of our cares upon you, Lord. We thank you because we know that whatever it is that we ask of you, in Jesus' name, believing in your word, is something that will come to pass in our lives. We declare, Father, that you touch the lives of all of those that are not here. Touch the lives of all those that come in our path, that we cross paths with you, Lord, that we interact, even if it's just for a second, that your light, Lord, shines through us to them. What do you say? Anyway, we're having a Mexican dinner after service, March 20th. Tacos, burritos, enchiladas.
Margaritas.
Spring your bottle.
And we're having House of Prayer this Friday. Speak the word. Would you not revive us again? That your people may rejoice in you. I am a believer, and these signs do follow me. In the name of Jesus, I cast out demons. I speak in new tongues. I lay hands on the sick, and they do recover. Christ has redeemed me from the curse of the law. Therefore, I forbid any sickness or disease to come upon this body. Every disease, germ, and every virus that touches this body dies instantly in the name of Jesus. Every organ and every tissue of this body functions to the perfection to which God created it to function. And I forbid any malfunction in this body in the name of Jesus. I receive the spirit of wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of him, the eyes of my understanding being enlightened, and I am not conformed to this world, but am transformed by the renewing of my mind. My mind is renewed by the word of God. The Lord rebukes the devourer for my sake, and no weapon that is formed against my finances will prosper. All obstacles and hindrances to my financial prosperity are now dissolved. The Lord has pleasure in the prosperity of his servant, and Abraham's blessings are mine.
Thank you. close as you want. Consume this heart that longs to burn. I know your fire can hurt, but I will be worse here without you. For I was made to dwell with you. And now I ache until I do. Take all these chains that get in the way of what you want. And as I stand in the flame, still I will say, I trust you, God. For I was made to dwell with you. And now I ache until I do. Holy God, take my heart, purged with flame and truth. A holy heart is all I want, that I may. So come to me, you who are in need of rest. Return to me, you who are in need of strength. Come to me, you who are in need of rest. Return to me, you who are in need of strength. Come to me, you who labor, you to me, so come to me, return to me, rest in me, so come to me. Returning, and the rest you shall be saved. In quietness and confidence shall be your strength. Isaiah 30:15. Matthew 11:28-29. Come to me, who you are labor and heavy of burden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find the rest in your souls. Rest in the Lord and wait for him patiently. Psalm 37:7. Yes, Lord. So come to me, you who are in need of rest. Return to me, you are in need of strength. Come to me, you are in need of rest. Return to me, you are in need of strength.
Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we love you. We appreciate your presence here tonight. Thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayer. And we know that if you hear them and it's in your will, that we have our petitions. So I thank you, Lord, for the good that will come. Thank you for those who have requested prayer. And Lord, we celebrate the victory for them right now.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, we declare it is done according to your word, Lord. So be it to them. Thank you, Jesus, for your faithfulness, your goodness, your grace, your mercy, and your great love for us.
Yes.
We bless you tonight, Lord, and we ask you just to minister to each of us, Lord,
mm-hmm.
as you have so far in the service, continue to, in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Give the Lord a hand clap. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Thank you again, abbreviated worship team. Praise the Lord. It's all testosterone up here. The women are all off somewhere. Praise the Lord. Well, we know they're scattered all over the place because praise the Lord. Yes, you did manage to keep the testosterone levels to a manageable level at least. Praise God. But thanks, Roberto. I appreciate your words this evening. Amen. It goes along with what I want to talk to you about, and I will be brief tonight. Some of you never believed that until Sunday. Praise the Lord. But I can be if I need to be or if I want to be. Praise God. So, but generally, we just kind of go on and on. Praise the Lord. But I knew there were goodies downstairs, and I didn't want the kids eating them all. That's what I heard anyway. Praise the Lord. So, anyway, remember Friday night, 7 o'clock, right? Praise the Lord. Eastern Gate House of Prayer, come and be part of it. And be a blessing and get blessed as you're at it. Praise the Lord. And then next, a week from this coming Sunday, will be our Mexican feast. Praise the Lord. So bring the Beano and any antacids that you can find and have a... and have a good time. Praise the Lord. So thank the Lord. Okay, well, let's get right into it. Praise God. Thank you all for being here tonight. And where two or three are gathered, the Lord's in the midst. So we know that God is here, and we'll just expect Him to be a continued blessing to us. Praise the Lord. All right, Mark chapter 1, we're going to read verses 14 and 15. Mark 1, verses 14 and 15. Praise God. God is good, isn't He? Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. All the time He's good. Praise God. After that, John was put in prison. Jesus came into Galilee preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel." Praise the Lord. Now, we know that the gospel actually translates good news. And the good news is that grace has come by Jesus Christ. Amen. The law came by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. And that's what Jesus is talking about here. The kingdom of God has come nigh. And they were still under the law at that point, but grace had already come in the person of Jesus Christ, and He was going to usher in, amen, this kingdom of God, amen, that would operate by the grace of Almighty God. So the time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God is at hand. Change your mind about how you look at God and believe the good news that grace has come. Praise the Lord. So when Jesus began His ministry, you know, He, right here on this planet Earth, the time that He spent here in ministry, the 3.5 years is really the period of time that He spent in ministry itself, He immediately began preaching and teaching. Now, as God incarnate, or the Son of God, you might expect that His messages would be full of all kinds of complex theology. I mean, after all, He's God in the flesh. He knows theology before we were able to even try to design it. Amen? But instead, His teachings were really simple. And gives me hope, praise the Lord. But basically, the kingdom of God has come near. Repent, change your mind about God, believe the good news, believe in grace. That was basically the message He was preaching in different ways, but that was the fundamental teaching that He had. He went about everywhere preaching the kingdom. Amen. Jesus wasn't a 5-point preacher. He wasn't a 3-point preacher. Jesus was a 1-point preacher. Praise the Lord. He preached the goodness of God, the grace of God, the mercy of God. And everywhere Jesus went throughout that 3.5 years of ministry, He taught good news. He taught grace. Praise the Lord. Now, again, the gospel is good news. And He went about everywhere preaching the gospel. Amen? So Jesus didn't just preach good news. Jesus was good news to people. Praise the Lord. Amen? Grace, as I said, came in the person of Jesus Christ. So He went about everywhere preaching, not just preaching to people the good news, but being good news to people. Matthew 11, 28 and 29. Praise the Lord. "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest." Thank you, Michael. Praise the Lord. "Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I'm meek and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls." Praise God. Throughout all the gospel accounts, you see Jesus feeding the hungry, taking care of the poor, restoring dignity to those that were had been shamed because of prostitution, thievery, whatever their issues might have been. He brought dignity back to them, casting out demons, healing the sick, doing all of those things. Everywhere he went in his ministry, that's what you saw. His life and ministry creates a great model for all of us. As followers, we can look to Jesus and see what it is we should do, right? Matthew chapter 4, verse 19. I'm going to give you several scriptures here in a row just to establish this. Follow me. And he saith unto them, follow me, and I'll make you fishers of men, right? Matthew 8, 22. These will all be in Matthew, by the way, Roberto. Jesus said unto them, follow me, let the dead bury their dead. 9:9. That's not German. Okay. As Jesus passed forth from thence, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the receipt of custom, and he said unto him, follow me. And he arose and followed him. 16:24. Said Jesus unto his disciples, we have a winner. Praise the Lord. No. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. Praise the Lord. 19, verse 21. At the risk of being redundant, I just want to establish, follow me, okay? Jesus said unto him, if thou wilt be perfect, go and sell all that thou hast, give to the poor, and thou shalt have treasure in heaven. Come and follow me. Praise the Lord. Matthew 11, 30. My yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Praise the Lord. So following Jesus isn't so much about following his perfection as an example or a standard to attain to or to reach, but more it's about getting wrapped up in the things that Jesus was wrapped up in. Praise the Lord. John chapter 15, verse 4. Abide in me, I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself except it abide in the vine, no more can ye except you abide in me. So actually following Jesus has less to do with whether you emulate his perfection and more about being good news to people. Praise the Lord. John 15, 5. I'm the vine, you're the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. Amen? So the question then becomes, are you good news to the people around you? Amen? Are you good news to the circle of influence that you have? Amen? Now, for me, sometimes my answer is good. I'm happy with it. Sometimes not so much. Praise the Lord. Because, you know, we can't dictate our circumstances. We can't dictate the circumstances that we find ourselves in. But we can decide how we affect those circumstances. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Amen. John chapter 9, verse 5. As long as I'm in the world, I'm the light of the world. John 12, 36. While you have light, believe in the light, that ye may be the children of light. These things spake Jesus, and departed, and did hide himself from them. Matthew chapter 5, verse 16. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. So here's the question again. Are you light? Are you good news to people? Now, I get it. You know, none of us are Jesus incarnate. So none of us are going to always be good news to everybody that we come into contact with. But don't let that reality stop you from answering the question in general terms. Along your path in life, are you good news? Praise the Lord. Now, over the years, I wasn't always so much good news. Even today, sometimes I can not be great news. But from a religious perspective, we don't realize that a lot of times we come into the path of people, or God puts people in our path, and we're not good news. We're bad news. We're scary news. We're frightening news. We're just negative news. Because we're not really following Jesus. We're not really abiding in Him and bearing His fruit. We're bearing religious fruit. We're establishing our own personal, doctrinal, denominational kind of attitudes instead of doing what Jesus did. He said, follow me. That means we ought to be doing what He did. Now, we can't be perfect, but we can bring good news to people. We can be good news. We can bring grace where there is condemnation and guilt and shame and judgment. Instead of that, we can bring grace. That's what He did. When He comes upon a person that's steeped in sin, His response to them was, you're going to bust hell wide open and you deserve it and I'm glad you're going there. No, it was, there's forgiveness. I don't condemn you either. Go and sin no more. Be blessed of your Father, which is in heaven. Amen? So I've received a lot of grace over the years, and I would like to feel like I can extend some. We had an insurance agent at our house yesterday afternoon, late, and we didn't really invite her, praise the Lord. Like often it happens, somebody else had a deal with them and gave them our name. We got a couple of freebies that I could have lived without, but nevertheless, she came to try to, obviously, to sell some insurance. And when she asked us, what we did, and we told her, and she said, oh, you're a pastor. And so from that point on, and she was depressed, we find out later, because of all kinds of issues, diabetes, all kinds of other things she has personally. One of her children has, a mental issue of some kind. I can't remember now what it's called. But just multiple things going on in her life. And it gave me an opportunity to be good news to her. And before it was all over, I think I spent more time talking to her than she did to me. Praise the Lord. She left blessed. She couldn't help. She couldn't stop thanking us for being able to, make her feel like her day hadn't been a total loss. Every place she'd been, it had been problems all day long. Anybody that's in sales, you know what I'm talking about. Praise the Lord. But we were able to be a blessing. We were able to be good news. Not just to bring good news to her, but actually to be good news. And we can do that. We didn't plan that. God planned it. We didn't plan it. It just happens because that's what God wants. Because as followers of Jesus, my wife is here today. So no point in me trying to lie to you. I make as many mistakes as anybody does. So I'm not perfect. I'm not Jesus incarnate. But I can still be good news. I can still follow Him. Praise the Lord. So, amen. I'm learning that when I'm good news to people, I'm given the opportunity to share good news with people. It's hard to share good news with people after you beat them up with the Bible, and interpretation. But what I've learned over time is that when I am good news to people, God gives me an opportunity then to share good news with people. Praise the Lord. Remember the TV show Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Now, first of all, I thought that was the dumbest title for any show. Duh. Who wants to be a millionaire, right? Okay. Anyway, it was a trivia game show, and I only watched it maybe once or twice. I don't know that I ever watched the whole thing, but I've always had this kind of dislike for Regis Philbin. Watch it every once in a while just to see if he'd screw up or something. But anyhow, I watched it a few times. And it was this trivia game show. And in order to win, you had to answer like 14 or 15 consecutive multiple choice questions correctly. And as it turns out, that's certainly not that easy to do. Even though it's trivia and they're multiple choice, it still wasn't real simple. And obviously, there weren't a lot of millionaires that came off of that show. The questions, kind of got my attention, though, was the questions got more and more difficult with each round that the money increased. Obviously, the questions got harder, right? So, Regis would ask, Is that your final answer? Anybody ever watch that? Y'all got TVs now? Or okay. So, with the... Yeah, I know. We prayed through over it, so it's all good now. But like the $100 question, you know, the $200 question, it was no big deal. I mean, it was not a lot of pressure. They didn't take a whole lot of time to think about it. Is that your final answer, right? I mean, they knew it's an easy question, so it wasn't a big deal. But if they made it to the $1 million question, their nerves started to come into play. Mm-hmm. Amen? And they'd squirm around, and of course the light's on them, and they'd begin to sweat a little bit, and they'd, you know, eyes kind of darting around, and you could see the wheels rolling in their head, and they're squirming, and they're trying to answer. And finally, Regis would say, "Is that your final answer?" And the tension would increase, because now there's a lot at stake. It's not $100, it's $1 million, right? Are you following Jesus? Are you good news? It's a question worth taking some time. It's a question worth taking seriously. But before you give your final answer, a caution needs to be given. Because it's possible, and I think religiously it often happens, to conclude as Christians our end goal is to be known as followers of Jesus. That's not true. The only purpose for our being known is that Jesus will be known. In the religious world, we have, it's all about us. It's all about me. It's all about this ministry. It's all about that ministry. It's always about somebody instead of being about Jesus. The only way for Jesus to be known is for good news to be shared, is for grace to be released. The only way for that to truly happen is for you to be good news. Can you say praise the Lord? Give him a hand. We're done. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. Yes. Y'all are blessed. Be good news. Hallelujah. It's not hard. All you got to do is give it away. Praise the Lord. Give him grace.
If you lift him up, he'll lift you up.
That's the truth. Praise God. Thank you. Hallelujah. Be blessed in Jesus' name. See you back here Sunday. I'll take a little more time. Don't have dinner reservations for noon, because I may not let you out at noon this time. Praise God. Last week you could have got into McDonald's for breakfast before they went to all-day breakfast.
There you go.
Praise God. You're dismissed in Jesus' name.